the hypervisor. The hypervisor is a compressed file that you are able to download from VMware. After you have this file ready in your computer, you are gonna have options to either burn it to a DVD or create a bootable flash drive. So why do you do this? You do this simply because you want this computer hardware to be a real hypervisor. At this point, this is just a regular computer hardware. It's not a hypervisor. So this computer hardware is gonna be a hypervisor after you install the hypervisor ESXi and finish the installation. So after that, you are gonna be able to share resources and create VMs or virtual machines. So what are the resources that you can give up to the new VMs? Resources are CPU, memory RAM, hard disk drive, and networking. So let's pretend that this computer right in the bottle is the new ESXi host. In the middle, we're gonna have the hypervisor, which is gonna be the layer of abstraction, right? So which is gonna get all the resources for the new VMs. And right on top, we have 6 virtual machines ready to use, right? So how do you do this? First, you need to know how much resources you have in this ESXi host. For example, you have to know how many CPUs, you have to know how much memory you have in this hypervisor, you have to know how much hard drive space you have, and you have to know how many NIC or network cards you have available, right? So for this example, let's pretend that you have 10 CPUs in this computer hardware. When I say computer, it can be a server, can be a laptop, can be a workstation, any endpoint device that you are gonna use as a hypervisor. Okay, when it comes to CPU, you also have to know, you know, how many sockets you are gonna have in this hypervisor, how many cores, and how many logical processors you are gonna get. But for this example, let's make it easy. Let's pretend that we have 10 CPUs. If you configure each VM with one CPU, this is gonna be 1 × 6 = 6, right? And then you end up with 4 CPUs spare. Okay, if you have a 32 gigabytes of RAM and you configure each VM with 4 gigabytes, this is gonna be 4 × 6 = 24, and then you end up with 8 gigabytes of memory RAM spare. Okay, now let's go to disk. A disk can be a local data store from the same hypervisor, or a data store from an external storage, right? So let's say that you have 200 gigabytes disk space, right? So for each VM, you are configuring 25 gigabytes of hard disk, and this is going to be 25 times 6, which is going to be 150. Then you end up with 50 gigabytes of hard disk drive space on this total storage, right? Finally, if we have one NIC card in this hypervisor, you can create as many virtual NIC cards in this virtual machine, but usually you are gonna have just one NIC card. So 1 × 6 = 6 VNICs, right? So you are taking 6 virtual NIC card out of this host computer to give it up to the VMs.